May the Lord bless you from Zion, and may you see the prosperity of Jerusalem all the days of your life, always, now, and ever, and forever.
You have Son of Man, whom you made strong for yourself.
God grant you many years, God grant you many years, God grant you many blessed years.
Lord, the Lord, look down from heaven and see and visit his vineyard and perfect where your right hand has planted. May your hand be upon the Son of Man, whom you may strong for yourself.
God grant you many years, God grant you many years, God grant you many blessed years.
Lord, O Lord, look down from heaven and see and visit his vineyard and perfect work your right hand has planted. May your hand be upon the Son of Man, whom you make strong for yourself.
God grant you many years, God grant you many years, God grant you many blessed years.
Lord, O Lord, look down from heaven and see and visit his vineyard and perfect for what your right hand has planted. May your hand be upon the Son of Man, whom you make strong for.
and fear God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Holy Brother Francis, Pope of Rome, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O most reverend Metropolitan William, for our God-loving Bishop Milan, for the venerable presbytery, the diaconate in Christ, and all the clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our government and for all in the service of our country, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city, for every city, community, and for the faithful living in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For favorable weather, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who travel by sea, air, and land, for the sick, the suffering, the captive, and for the salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That we may be delivered from all affliction and wrath in need, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Protect us, save us, have mercy on us, and preserve us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Remembering our most holy, most pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever-Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To you, Lord.
Lord our God, mighty beyond description, glorious above all understanding, merciful without limits, loving us all beyond expression, love with compassion, honest and honest Holy Spiritual Master, and show us and us to pray with us the riches of your tender mercy. For to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, is you all glory, honor, and worship, now and ever and forever.
Amen. Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
wisdom be attentive.
Come, let us worship him before Christ. O Christ, you are the true light, where the light is and sanctifies everyone coming into the world.
Glory. sense.
Let us be attentive.
Brethren, live as children of light. Light produces every kind of goodness and justice and truth. Be correct in your judgment of what pleases the Lord. Take no part in vain deeds done in darkness. Rather, condemn them. It is shameful even to mention the things these people do in secret. But when such deeds are condemned, they are seen in the light of the day. All that then appears is light. That is why we read, "Awake, O sleeper, rise from the dead, and Christ will give you light." Keep careful watch over your conduct. Do not act like fools, but like thoughtful men. Make the most of the present opportunity, for these are evil days. Do not continue in ignorance, but try to discern the will of the Lord. Avoid getting drunk on wine that leads to debauchery. Be filled with the Spirit, addressing one another in psalms and hymns and inspired songs. Sing praise to the Lord with all your hearts.
If the reader
wisdom be attentive.
On their way there, they were cured.
One of them, realizing that he had been cured, came back praising God in a loud voice. He threw himself on his face at the feet of Jesus and spoke his praises. This man was a Samaritan. Jesus took the occasion to say, "Were not all 10 made whole? Where are the other 9? Was there no one to return and give thanks to God except this foreigner?" He said to the man, "Stand up and go your way. Your faith has been your salvation."
Glory to you, Lord. Glory to you.
God grant you many years. God grant you many years. God grant you many blessed years. The Holy Spirit will descend upon you, and the power of the Most High, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory to you.
Father, all the brothers and sisters in Christ, the inheritance of St. Nicholas. We have so many, you know, occasional feasts that I don't know which whom I need to, you know, to start. But at the first is that today is Holy Resurrection. Every Sunday when we arrive in the church is the Holy Resurrection of Jesus Christ. And this is a substantial, you know, of all our feasts and all our reasons why we are arriving in the church. Why we are as a Christians gathering together every Sunday on Divine Liturgy and as a brothers and sisters to praise God for all what we received. Other feasts in all liturgical year has they are consequences of this feast of Jesus' resurrection. Because without Jesus, surely other feast. And so this reason after we can also celebrate the maternity of the Saint Anne, the Mother of God, the Virgin Mary, who is celebrating also today. Because God in your ineffable, you know, the plan, he scheduled, you know, to arrive in Jesus. What we are waiting in this very fast on the nativity of Jesus. That first he is preparing his mom. And this is normal, it's a usual. If baby is arriving on the world, we need to prepare also to accept and prepare to birth the baby on this world. And so God is planning, you know, all, you know, in this ineffable, you know, plans, all this schedule that we are naming. We are speaking about history of the salvation. That all, you know, the Old Testament, all prophets, all, you know, the Moses, all, you know, these prophets were in this plan intended to arriving in the Messiah, to Jesus Christ. And this is wonderful. And also we have, you know, in this schedule of the plan, this story of salvation is still going on. Because also St. Nicholas, your patron of your church and your parish, and the oldest parish, you know, in Detroit area, is not for casual, you know, chose as a, you know, patron. Because for everybody, also from, you know, and your ancestors, you know, even from Europe and everywhere, they knew that St. Nicholas is a symbol of their goodness. Symbol of the Christian love, symbol of the expression of the, you know, the good things, good deeds, and we can say also good thoughts. And St. Nicholas really, you know, he challenges everybody of us to remember what is, you know, the most important our vocation as a Christian. It is our love. Love is more important, brothers and sisters. Nothing else. Business and other things in church is not our priority. As I wrote in my letter, in a pastoral letter from the beginning of September, maybe you remember this, that you know the precious in the church, you are the precious in the church, because without you, we can have to have wonderful churches, but if they remain empty, it's done. But if you will be there with your kids, with your grandkids, this is a church. This is our future. That we as a brothers and sisters, that we as a flock, we are journeying, you know, in heavenly kingdom. And together. So don't worry. Dear brothers and sisters, don't worry about future, about our future. If you have bishops still here, don't worry. If you have priests here, don't worry about your future. If you have young guys here, don't worry. If you have kids here, I have, you know, ECF here. So it was a wonderful conversation with them. I don't see that everybody's in choir and altar, it's wonderful. So don't worry about your future. But please, maintain your witness. Maintain your testimony for them. To be for them the witnesses of Jesus Christ. It's our task. Maybe you elder maybe ask, what I need to do in this church? So your task is important. Your business, in sense, you know, your responsibility is important. You know what? To show the younger generation that you honestly and with God and with your faith, you live your life. And this is a message. What we need to go and to give, you know, this world who is full of hopeless, they hasn't, you know, sense. They hasn't gone. They are living for today. For sense, what will be tomorrow? Nobody knows. We will see. And maybe government in D.C., Washington, D.C. will be taken care of. No. We are here, and we are here as a citizen of the United States. As a Christians, we take responsibility, and we have influence to change this culture. It's our duty that this culture will be Christian culture. Because every Christian denomination that arrived from Europe, they arrived as a Christians. They arrived as, you know, the Jesus Christ. Was in their hearts. Doesn't matter how the denomination. They believe in Jesus Christ. And this is a point, a very strong point, why I want, you know, to underline also for you as a message for future, also for your parish in St. Nicholas Clifton Town. Because St. Nicholas is an example also for us, for the goodness, for the concrete love. He wasn't excluded, you know, to be involved in, you know, the troubles of this world. He wasn't escaping as a bishop, you know, from, you know, for this world. No, he went going, you know, to people, to hear them, to understand them, their troubles, their challenges, their problems. They crying, they weeping, and also they joys. This is a church that we be together, we be, you know, as a solidarity together and empathic to others with Christian values. What are, who are, which are today, you know, obstacles, and they are in danger. And we don't hesitate to speak about this. also allowed, because this is our duty. Duty to defend the life, duty to defend human life from unborn kids to honest death of elder people. And church, also Catholic Church, has to, you know, defend, you know, this position for forever. Because if you know, the Catholic Church will be, you know, not be, you know, trustful in this, he loses his God. She loses, you know, his God as his sense. And also the gospel of today, you know, is challenging us and inviting us to be grateful to God. You know, there were 10 guys. 10 guys were healed, but only one come back. Interesting, no? Jesus asked him, this, you know, poor Samaritan, and we are under 9. They didn't receive the grace of God? Where are these other 9? He didn't receive answer from him. But what he did, this is, you know, question for us. You know, this question of Jesus is for us. What is other 9? Maybe in this church, who were baptized here, on this place, they didn't receive the grace of God. They forgot that God loves them. And what they received from God, not from me, even not from you. We are only, you know, the mediators. As a parent, and every parent are only mediators to give the gift of God to your kids. Because remember, also your kids, they are not your. It's your not own. They belong to God. Don't forget it, please. But it also hope today, also for us. Don't worry. Maybe you think, yes, my kids are not going to church. Don't worry. Have hope. Because your prayers of you, your parents, can you not bring, come back your kid? Believe me. Believe me or no? Do you think it's possible or no? I'm not hearing nothing.
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
So thanks to God that we have this hope. Because it's important. We are holding all the hope. Christians are people who have hope, who have hope. This is a Christians today. If we will have hope, dear brothers and sisters, we are blessed. Because you know, these 10 leprous guys, they had hope. They had hope and they cried to Jesus, "Oh Lord God, have pity on us." And this is our position. We need to cry to God. Every Divine Liturgy here, have pity on us, have mercy on us, Lord have mercy. This is the reason why we are repeating always and always, you know, every Divine Liturgy is Lord have mercy. Because this is an expression of our faith, this is an expression of our hope, that we believe to you, in you Jesus, God Almighty. And we are glorifying you as this unique, this Samaritan who was arriving to Jesus. Because on the end, what he said, what Jesus said to him, your faith healed you, my son. Your faith! And this is, you know, challenge also for us today. Maybe we can ask, how is my faith? Everybody of us, you know, has right to, you know, put an answer. How is my faith today, in 2019, in this my age, in this my position, in my family? Your faith can grow. Your faith also today, if you are young or you are elder, can grow. How? By prayer. Please, brothers and sisters, pray at your homes, please. Don't shy each other. Don't shy you as, you know, couples to invite each other, you know, to prayer. To pray every day together. We are able to talk and talk hours about nothing. But we are not able, you know, to be together and to pray together. Why? What is the obstacle for us? Are you shy before your husband to say that you are a believer? Are you shy before your wife that you are a believer? Are you shy before your kids to invite them to say, come on, we are going to pray, because we receive many gifts from God. Because, brothers and sisters, gratitude is a big gift from God. We are not honest. We are not honest to receive these gifts. God give us gratitude. Gratis. Do you think that we have not, you know, for what to tell Him thank you? Are you convinced that we have not, you know, to say every day, to say to God, Almighty God, thank you? I think so. I think so that every day we have, you know, to say, God, thank you. And in church, in Jewish tradition, and also, you know, in our Christian Eastern tradition, this thank you is expressed in glorifying God. If we are glorifying God, this means that we are telling Him, thank you, God. Thank you, God, for my life. Thank you for my wife. Thank you for my husband. Thank you for my kids, for my siblings. Thank you for my church. Thank you for my bishop. Thank you for my priest. Do you think that we have not to say thank you to God? We have many. Believe me, on the end of our life, we have not been able to prepare to say thank God. So, brothers and sisters in Christ, we are preparing for Christmas. And you know, maybe you are asking how gift I can give my husband, my wife, what I need to buy here. Don't worry about this. I think that the biggest gift you are each other for your husband, for your wife. You as a parent, you are the biggest God gift for your kids. And you kids, you are the biggest, you know, gift from your parents. You don't need it when you know the crazy gift. It's not our goal as a Christians, brothers and sisters. Thanks to God, we have to eat. We have where to sleep. Thanks to God. 3 days ago was, you know, the accident happened, you know, in Slovakia, in Prešov, in East Slovakia. You know, the gas was, you know, bomb. You know, 5 to 7 people lose their life. 40 people, you know, in hospital. 40 families lose their houses. This is a tragedy, brothers and sisters. If you will know when you will be celebrating Christmas, if you in one moment are losing all, and these people, you know, in news, they told, we lose all, but we save our life. Thanks to God. We save our life. This is, you know, this is a really problem. And now this is what we need, you know, to invent as a gift. The best Christmas gift, you know what will be? Your pure hearts. Then you will be prepared with your clean heart for Christmas. And you know how is, you know, the best, you know, manner, how to, you know, prepare for this. You know? What? Wonderful. only confession. So I pray you, I beg you, prepare for this Christmas with good confession. This will be, you know, the best gift from Jesus. Believe me. Humble heart, pure heart, prepared to accept Him as a baby boy in your heart. You have Father Joe here. You have Father Michael, you have Father John, you're already priest, thanks to God. Don't hesitate, not to be unpolite. There is ministry, and they have two to do. Because for this reason they are priests. To be in ministry to you. Do you understand? So to go, to call, tomorrow, to make appointment with fathers, and to prepare, and to go. As you go to cut hair, with enlightenment, with preparation, with appointment, I believe that you don't forget for this. And you know now, a holy Christmas, a holy confession. So come on, I encourage you, brothers and sisters, we need to do more for our salvation. Jesus gave us eternal life. How is our answer? Jesus is waiting. Jesus Christ is waiting for your answer. Your concretely answer. Don't fear. And don't worry. Because God is good. But He needs also to see our gratitude. So the brothers and sisters in the time of, do you know, that Philip asked for this Christmas, keep your hope, keep your faith, keep your, develop your love, because this is what we need. And also Christmas not will be only one day, but all year and all our life. Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory to you.
Merciful and loving God,
Thank you.
God, remember this kingdom. All you Christians of the true faith, always, now, and ever, and forever.
May the Lord God remember his kingdom. Our God, loving Bishop Milan, always, now, and ever, and forever.
May the Lord God remember his kingdom, Holy Father Francis Pope of Rome, our modern metropolitan of Milan, then type with the ark of the monastic orders, our government, all in the service of our country, and the ever-memorable founders and benefactors of this holy church. May the Lord God remember all you Christians of the true faith,
always, now and ever, and forever.
Lord, have mercy.
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 to offer the holy anaphora in peace.
Mercy, peace.
We also thank you for this liturgy, which you are pleased to accept from our hands, even though they are stand before you thousands of archangels, tens of thousands of angels, cherubim, seraphim, six women, eye, soaring aloft on their wings. Singing, shouting, crying aloud, and saying a triumphal hymn.
Of sins.
Amen.
honor and excellent Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Amen.
The mercies of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with all of you. Receive them on his holy, heavenly, and mystical altar as an aroma of spiritual fragrance, and send out upon us in return his divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
Asking for unity in the faith and for communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To you, Lord.
And make us both your master, and be made in confidence with the condemnation they call you Father, God of heaven and say,
simple God,
and bless your inheritance.
Lord, hear the answer. We have seen God through light. We have received the heavenly spirit. We have found the true way, and we worship the
always, now and ever, and forever. Church here, Byzantine Catholic Church, our presence here in Detroit, in this, the oldest parish of Detroit, our Byzantine Catholic parish. So thank you so much. And today we are continuing, you know, the celebration. As you know, it's a feast of Nicholas, and we have this, you know, the patronal feast, Opust, that right now will be Mirovanie, because it's a feast also for St. Nicholas, but also the conception of the St. Anne, of the Mother of God. And after we'll be around here inside the church, will be in procession with reading the four Gospels as a sign, because outside is a little bit freeze, frozen. So I will preserve you to not go to outside, but next time we will go outside. Okay. So prepare. Because you know, this is a sign of the proclamation of the Gospel all around you, the neighbors here. That they will know that we are present here. We can't be only closed, you know. We need to be open. Our doors and windows have to be open to come back. Others will come to others. Because we have to offer them more Jesus Christ. We don't have to be in fear, concern. We have to be joyful that we can to offer. Okay? So thank you again. for everybody that we can to be together, myself as a shepherd, where I do not do. Encourage you to go forward. Don't worry, we need to go. Okay? Okay, thanks. To Father Joseph, to Father Paul with family, to all priests in monastic orders, to all our brothers and sisters in Christ, to all parishioners and to prison guests, and to all Christians of the true faith, grant, O Lord, many years.